A buffer solution's pH remains relatively stable despite adding significant amounts of H+ or OH- ions. A buffer solution contains significant amounts of a weak acid, HA, and its conjugate weak base, A-. By significant amounts, we mean more than the amount expected from the partial ionization of either the weak acid or the weak base. We can achieve this by directly adding both the weak acid and a salt of the conjugate base to water. We can also achieve this by partially titrating a solution of the weak acid, or partially titrating a solution of the conjugate base. Note that HA and A- are the only acid-base pair that cannot neutralize themselves. Reacting the two is a proton transfer that yields the same two starting molecules. HA yields the proton to become A-, and the original A- ion accepts the proton to become HA. Finally, the pH of a buffer solution is very stable. Added H+ ions are immediately consumed by the weak base A- to produce HA, and added OH- ions are immediately consumed by the weak acid HA to produce A-. To calculate the pH of a buffer solution, always use the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. In this equation, pKa is the base 10 logarithm of HA's dissociation constant, Ka. The equation technically requires the concentrations of the weak acid and conjugate base. However, these two coexist within the same solution, and therefore share the same volume. The ratio of the two concentrations is the same as the ratio of the number of moles. It is often easier to work with moles in an ice table, as we need not concern ourselves with volume changes that arise when mixing two solutions together, and would alter the concentrations. Finally, do not overthink the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. No matter the way the problem is formulated, use the equation as is. Also, the weak acid and its conjugate base cannot react with one another. Therefore, if you are told how much HA and A- are in solution, apply the equation immediately. Or, if you partially titrate HA with OH- or A- with H+, take the partial neutralization into account to find out how much of the reactant is consumed and how much of the product is produced, which is one and the same, and then apply the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation right away. As just mentioned, the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation can be very useful to calculate the pH in the midst of a titration. However, we use the technique seen in the previous chapter to calculate the pH before the titration starts, and we have either just the weak acid or the conjugate base. At the end of the titration of a weak acid, all of the weak acid is converted to the weak conjugate base. The solution will be slightly basic and have a pH higher than 7. At the end of the titration of a weak base, all of the weak base is converted to the weak conjugate acid. The solution will be slightly acidic and have a pH lower than 7. And to calculate the precise pH, simply take into account that the number of moles is the same as what you had at the beginning, but do not forget that the titration involved a dilution as the volume has progressively increased during the titration.